Oh no, SpaceX is facing problems with Booster 10. Are they able to fix it? What happened to the Falcon 9 booster? Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. Booster 10, a key component of the Starship launch system, faced some unexpected challenges during its testing phase. After the booster's transportation to the launch site and successful purge tests, SpaceX encountered issues during the propellant loading process. Venting of liquid oxygen and methane was observed, and frost formation on the booster's tanks indicated ongoing loading attempts. However, the loading process was eventually halted, and levels were below those observed in previous static fires with Booster 9. The prolonged venting from the orbital launch mount raised questions about potential technical issues with the new subcoolers or valves in the system. The decision to open Highway 4 for liquid oxygen dumping indicated a need to troubleshoot and address the challenges faced during Booster 10's testing. Also, when I checked the Cameron County website for road closures, I can see a possible road closure for tomorrow, December 27th from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. I think this closure is for the testing of Booster 10 again to analyze the problem that I mentioned earlier. Along with this, two new road closures has been scheduled for December 28th and December 29th from 12 a.m. to 3 a.m. These closures are definitely for the transport of Booster 10 back to the build site. Anyway, let's see how SpaceX is going to move ahead with Booster 10. Furthermore, Booster 10, after receiving final touch-ups, rolled out to the launch site on Christmas-themed transporters. The booster was positioned between tower arms and a purge test of all outer 20 Raptor quick disconnects on the orbital launch mount was conducted. This test, along with the booster's subsequent activities, grid fin and igniter tests were conducted on Booster 10. Concerning the static fire test for Booster 10, a full engine static fire is anticipated before the end of the year, contingent on the resolution of any issues encountered during the prototype testing. The timeline for this largely depends on the efficiency of identifying and addressing the problem, including the potential need to return the prototype to the build site. SpaceX has a track record of swift progress, and considering their history, the resolution is expected to be prompt. Notably, the company is making rapid advancements in preparation for the Orbital Flight Test 3. Starship testing and launch site preparations. Now, Starship is currently in an exciting phase of rigorous testing and preparation for upcoming launches. Ship 28, the latest in the Starship series, recently underwent a series of critical movement tests and a full-length testing at the Boca Chica, Texas facility. These tests involve the activation of all four flaps, replicating a sequence seen in a previous Starship iterations like Ship 24 and Ship 25. Notably, the launch site has been equipped with new liquid oxygen subcoolers and pumps, a significant addition to the orbital tank farm. These subchillers play a crucial role in expediting propellant loading, reducing boil-off, and ultimately facilitating quicker launch turnarounds. The recent static fire test of Ship 28 marked the first operational use of these subcoolers, showcasing SpaceX's commitment to optimizing its launch processes. The static fire of Ship 28's six Raptor engines was a pivotal moment in the testing phase. The full-duration static fire, capturing the ignition of both sea-level and vacuum engines, showcased the power and readiness of the Starship's propulsion system. The successful test was not without its challenges, as some thermal tile damage occurred, highlighting the need for ongoing refinements in the testing process. Importantly, Ship 28's static fire marked a significant step forward in SpaceX's capabilities, showcasing advancements in engine testing and integration procedures. It also provided valuable insights into potential improvements needed for future static fire tests. SpaceX's decision to explore alternative testing locations with higher stands reflects the company's commitment to continuous improvement and safety. Payload bay door developments. One noteworthy development during the testing phase was the opening of Ship 28's payload bay door. This marked the first instance of a payload bay door being opened while integrated on a full Starship vehicle. Previous iterations had permanently welded payload bay doors due to structural concerns. The successful deployment of Ship 28's payload bay door indicates SpaceX's confidence in the new design's structural reinforcement. This development has implications for future Starship missions, suggesting that SpaceX has made advancements in payload bay door technology, enabling greater flexibility in payload deployment and retrieval. The ability to open and close the payload bay door while integrated on the vehicle enhances the versatility and adaptability of the Starship for a variety of mission profiles. Launch timeline and FAA approval. Kathy Luders, the general manager at Starbase, provided insights into the anticipated launch timeline for the third integrated flight test. Despite Elon Musk's initial preference for a late 2023 launch, Kathy mentioned a projected timeframe of quarter one in 2024. This adjusted timeline aligns with the continuous progress observed in recent weeks, but it also highlights the complexity of coordinating various testing elements and obtaining regulatory approvals. The Federal Aviation Administration, FAA, plays a crucial role in approving launches, and the completion of the mishap report is a key milestone in this process. The mishap report, detailing any issues encountered during previous tests, must be finalized for SpaceX to receive the necessary approvals. The timeline for FAA approval is a critical factor in determining the feasibility of a January launch or potential delays. Starship program expansion. Kathy Luder's insights into the future of the Starship program provided a glimpse into SpaceX's expanding ambitions. Beyond the prototype testing phase, SpaceX is gearing up for multiple Starship launches in the coming year. This shift signifies a transition from testing individual components to launching the next generation of Starlink satellites and attempting ship and booster recoveries. The readiness to erect a second orbital launch pad at Starbase further emphasizes SpaceX's commitment to increased launch frequency. A second launch tower not only supports more frequent launches, but also facilitates crucial practice sessions for booster and ship catching. This strategic move aligns with SpaceX's long-term goals of operationalizing Starship for a variety of missions, including crewed spaceflights and lunar exploration. Mega Bay and vehicle production. Mega Bay 1, a key facility in Starship vehicle production, continues to play a pivotal role in assembling and stacking various components. Recent activities include the movement of a new booster after section into the bay, followed by stacking with the existing liquid oxygen tank. The forward section, after assembly, was rolled out to Mega Bay, setting the stage for future stacking processes. Noteworthy additions to the production process include a brand new booster processing stand and a nose cone welding jig. The booster processing stand, the third of its kind, contributes to the efficiency of booster-related work in the bays. The welding jig, located in the expanded part of the Star Factory, is a crucial tool for maintaining precision in the fabrication of nose cones. Future endeavors and lunar mission plans. Looking ahead, SpaceX's vision for the Starship program extends beyond prototype testing and into a phase of operational launches. Kathy Luder's confirmation of multiple Starship launches next year signals a more dynamic phase in the program's development. The upcoming missions include not only deploying Starlink satellites, but also attempting the first recovery of a ship and booster. These recovery attempts are crucial milestones in the roadmap, leading to ambitious missions like Artemis 3, where astronauts are slated to return to the surface of the moon. Kathy's acknowledgement of SpaceX's readiness to erect a second orbital launch pad at Starbase indicates a strategic move to further optimize operations. A second launch tower provides a platform for practicing booster and ship catching, mitigating risks associated with the primary launch tower and supporting the overall maturation of the Starship program. With these developments, 2024 is poised to be a transformative year for SpaceX and the Starship program. Now, we will discuss about what exactly happened to SpaceX's Falcon 9 booster, B-1058. SpaceX's Falcon 9 booster, celebrated for completing 19 successful landings, faced an unexpected setback recently. Despite its impressive history, the booster encountered rough weather during its return to Florida, causing it to topple over on the droneship in the Atlantic. This incident is a rare occurrence for a booster that had previously demonstrated flawless reusability. The Falcon 9, featuring NASA's recognizable worm logo from the 2020 Demo 2 mission, showcased SpaceX's expertise in reusing rocket components. However, the adverse weather conditions during its transportation proved to be a formidable challenge. It's worth noting that newer Falcon boosters are now equipped with enhanced landing legs designed to self-level, minimizing the risk of such incidents. Unfortunately, the ill-fated booster did not benefit from this upgraded feature. The booster's last mission involved successfully launching 23 Starlink satellites before attempting its final landing on the droneship. Beyond this mission, the booster played a crucial role in the historic Crew Demo 2 flight in 2020, signifying the return of human spaceflight from the Space Coast after a decade-long hiatus. Throughout its remarkable career, the Falcon 9 booster contributed to various missions, including Anisys 11, CRS-21, Transporter 1, Transporter 3, and numerous Starlink deployments. SpaceX proudly highlighted the booster's achievements, revealing that it launched 2 astronauts and over 860 satellites, accumulating a total payload of more than 260 metric tons in just over 3.5 years. While this incident represents a setback for SpaceX, it's essential to recognize the company's overall success with 256 landings among its Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets. Remarkably, this mishap marks the first lost booster since February 2021, underscoring the reliability of SpaceX's reusability efforts. Looking ahead, SpaceX maintains a promising future with numerous launches planned for the year. The company's unwavering commitment to reusability and exploration continues to push boundaries, demonstrating resilience even in the face of occasional setbacks. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.